music that functions to let us all know that something is starting. It's dramatic enough for you to take notice. It's gently persuading you that something meaningful is about to happen. Talking in the audience tends to stop now. Here we are, sat in the dark, taking time to forget and to remember about life. Simultaneously, as the lights go down, you look in front of you, begin to relax a little. You take a breath, and then as you sit back in your seat, you remember. Check once more if your mobile phone is off. It is off. But the shame of it going off in a silent bit is too risky not to check it again. You do this to the music and it becomes meaningful. Your face is temporarily lit up by the phone's light. You look beautiful. Music begins to fade away really, really slowly so that you don't notice it too much. It fades away, perhaps leaving some anticipation. Let's hope so. Music gradually fades, slowly. Lights come up. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My mother often tells me that she does not understand dance.
I don't understand dance.
So in homage to her, I thought I would explain everything. Mother, there is nothing to understand. Here comes the meaningful silence that supports us in a moment of contemplation. Here I am, trying to be here looking present, looking like I am really here and now. So I am standing, trying to be here, not anywhere else but here, not even just then, not even later on, but here, standing in uncertainty, looking like I am enjoying it. I am not one of those people who just loves performing. I fucking hate it most of the time. I keep trying not to do it, but I just end up here. Somehow, I begin dancing, changing direction lots and lots and lots of times. I stop to take you in, then I run away, then I run back at you. I keep repeating this. It is portraying doubt and uncertainty. There is usually a lot of it at the beginning of any performance. What are we expecting from each other tonight? Lights down. More down. And bring them up again, as if time has passed. Lights up, I come to the front of the stage where there is a spot. I look at the audience and I make a gesture where my lips press together to suggest surrender and a yielding to vulnerability. I look to the diagonal in a meaningful way, coloring the action in order to make it interesting for both you and me. I walk to the diagonal and arrive and look up to the sky as if connecting to something higher than me. Perhaps searching for answers or something I don't yet know. I look like I hear something outside the building and turn my head meaningfully, again to suggest more suspense than the last meaningful look I did at the beginning. I walk toward another part of the space, which lights up when I walk towards it. This space could be outside, or in a kitchen perhaps. I stop and look like I know why I came here. I look like I might be waiting. I leave that place out. I come back looking puzzled and come to the spot again to stand. I stand and see you and I press my lips together again, which suggests surrender. Perhaps I press them tighter, but this pressing of the lips could be confused with puzzlement. Both surrender and puzzlement seem close. I walk to the diagonal and look up. This time my hands join and perhaps suggesting a more pleading-like quality. I keep going with this. The next 20 seconds are for you to have some time with yourself in which to reflect. Here are some things that might have come to mind as associations to the last image. Searching for God. Waiting for God. Angry with God. Flying a professional kite. Taking down the duvet from the cupboard because I have a friend staying at my house. These are all possible means of understanding what just happened. I pretend to hear something meaningfully again. Perhaps hold this best this time. But not too much. That would be incongruent. I walk towards that spot. I look again for something or someone. I am concerned about my out-breath being too dramatic. That might suggest frustration. I wonder that I might be frustrated. I'm trying to illuminate something about repetition and expectation. I am probably trying too hard. This has always been an issue of mine. I think I'm even doing it again. Now be still. Sometimes, the most meaningful thing I can do is to be still. Sometimes, the most meaningful thing I can do is to move as much as I can without stopping. I think life is like this. I walk back to the spot where I began. I watch you, watching me, and I improvise for the next 10 seconds and respond directly to the feeling of watching you, watching me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Press my lips together to suggest surrender again because I feel rushed. It's hard to surrender authentically. Maybe that's not the point. I have a sense I don't know what that means anymore. Anyway, I keep coming back. I improvise for the next 10 seconds and trying to be authentic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I look to the diagonal in a meaningful way, coloring the action in order to make it interesting for both me and you. I make the action larger this time so that we feel we are actually going somewhere with this. Sometimes life is like this. I color the action to make it interesting for myself and others. I smile, even when I don't want to. I stay at a party when I know as soon as I walk through the door I want to leave. I wear a shirt to meet my father because I think he will see me more and love me more. I offer my crisps to my friend when actually I want to eat them all myself. Sometimes I use long words which I don't actually understand what they mean. I smile and nod with people who use them. Like I know what they're talking about. Sometimes performing is about telling the truth. Sometimes performing is about being believed. Sometimes being believed is about being alive. Sometimes being alive is about dancing. I raise my arms again. Perhaps searching for answers or something I don't yet know. I hear some nothing outside the building and turn my head meaningfully again to suggest more suspense than the last look, which was also meaningful. I walked all that space which lights up when I walk towards it, again. While late perhaps, I stand as if I'm waiting with more urgency. I come back looking puzzled and come to the spot again to stand. I keep coming back. It's about time for a meaningful silence. Here it is. I come to the front of the stage where there is a spot. Again. I look at the audience and I make a gesture where my lips press together to suggest a surrender and a yielding to vulnerability. I look to the diagonal in a meaningful way, and I become angry. I walk to the diagonal and arrive and look up to the sky as if connecting to something higher than me, perhaps searching for answers or something I don't yet know. Pleasing to hear some nothing outside the building and turn my head meaningfully again to suggest more suspense than the last meaningful one. I get out of the gate and I walk toward a mass space which lights up when I walk towards it. I look for something or someone.
My name is Ellen Thomas. I am the performer's mother. Here I am, sitting in the front with this prop. I have been asked to hand my son this puzzle at this point. He says it's vital for the development of the piece.
I will open it now.
Okay, so I see. The box is a metaphor for life, its fullness, its possibility. How we fill it with meaning, in the hope to understand it. But you say there's nothing to understand. Where does that leave us?
5, 4, 3, 2. There is nothing. It is empty of anything. All that anticipation and then.
Which is always difficult because there is still so much to say. And still so very little to understand. Sometimes when I dance, I like to imagine deep in my mind that this dance, here and now, will be my last. A surge of life comes through me. I come to the front of the stage where there is a spot. I press my lips together to suggest a surrender and yielding to vulnerability. I look at you directly and tell you, Ladies and gentlemen, here comes the end. Here it comes. After this bit. You ready?